Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Now, finally on the better headset, you don't have to hear all that static and crackling and stuff. We're here in Ilion and trying to sell those demon spears or whatever they are. Oh. The door is locked, and from within you hear an angry voice. We are closed. Come back later. 720. Where's the little thingy? That it is. Getting late. Five p.m. All right. We're gonna just park ourselves in front of the door until. What time did it say? Nine. Well, I'm like not paying attention. Yeah, 9 a.m. It's got regular 9 to 5 hours. Sorry, the horrible music is back. So if I wait 14 hours... No kidding, we're getting tired. Yes, yes, your incredible bargains. Oh, I am not interested in this trinket. Really? He won't buy the demon skewers at all. I mean, I wonder if someone else would buy them. Or they're just completely useless. That's so disappointing. Especially after waiting in front of his shop for 14 hours. Give us a break, man. I mean, I don't think there's much else we have to sell. Regular hat. Does he have the space though? He doesn't. If I gave him one, I couldn't even sell him a demon skewer because he doesn't have any space. I don't suppose we have any of that stuff to sell. Extra. You know, when I was funny, when I bought Firebrand, I thought it was a unique named item. Now there's like so many of them. All these demon skewers. I'm gonna keep one, I guess, and sell the rest, just in case we need it for something, I guess. There's a lot of arrows. Okay. Leaving in defeat. We're gonna throw some stuff in the beginning, the starter house, guys, and I'll be back after that. Okay, storing some stuff away. We threw out all the demon skewers, or except one, right? We want to put one before I forget. We filled up most of these chests except for this one. This one, I'm afraid, is like not usable or cursed. I'm afraid to put stuff in there because of the way it's like that. We're gonna teach him, as far as him, Nelvin. Okay. Some of these spells. And we. Two of us got hurt, we walked through a stream, don't worry about it. Happens all the time. We're gonna give him the Lich Crown, which to remind, gives a plus 50 to reading magic, so he'll be unlimited reading magic. I'm just gonna swap this out here, and as you see, he's without limit ultimate power. actually, here. I don't know how much of this can learn. I don't know about Wind Howler. Or Fire Beam. Because unfortunately... the names don't exactly match. Translation is a little bit different. These are the destruction spells. I mean, maybe... I think we have a whirlwind, though, in the game. It's called Whirlwind. So maybe Wind Howler is not on here? In any case, he doesn't know Wind Howler. And, he doesn't know Fireball. I'm gonna try to learn him some Fireball here. And... not Firestorm yet. Column of Fire, not yet either. But we have a Fire Beam. Which, Column of Fire in this game is called Fire Pillar. And I think Firestorm is actually just called Firestorm. I don't see a Fire Beam. Unless it's... I don't know. So, in any case... just in case things get messed up. Let's just throw in a little save here, in case it's not what I thought it would be or something. Alright, so Nelvin. Going into resting. Attempting to learn, well, first of all, Fireball, which should use 15 learning points. At this point, he has 83. So he should be fine for this. Fireball. He manages his spell. Now he has 68 spell learning points left. 68. So what about this Fire Beam? So that was 10 learning points. I'm trying to figure out if this is even on here. Spell learning points. He already knew Magic Arrow, didn't he? Unless I got it confused with Magic Arrow. These are all the 10s. Landslide. Typhoon? Can't be Typhoon. Flamethrower. I guess this is Flamethrower. Fire Beam is Flamethrower. That's pretty off. Okay. I didn't even spot it there because I was just looking for fire or something. Alright, so we got Fire Beam, or Flamethrower. And we still got some left, so... Earthquake? She has now. Okay. That was 15. Earthquake. Well, that's actually on the list here. Which is good. Earthquake here. 30 spell points to cast. Ooh, this is good because he had a lot of learning points. Soon to not have much. Cause Madness, Wind Howler? I forgot how much we had. Did we just go down 10 from 43? Not sure. Wind Howler. Typhoon, I guess? Single opponent. I'm guessing it's Typhoon. It's hard to match up these spells. Especially destruction spells, out of any of them, seem to be the most off with that translation there. And... he still has some, so let's... oh, I didn't want to sleep till dawn. Oh, okay. That's fine, though. Yes. But he went down in spell points. Cause madness. Okay, so now he's got just 23 left. He's got all these spells. We are increasing his repertoire. His inventory repertoire. That's pretty awesome. So he only has 23. I might just save it, because the big spells coming up, I want to be able to have him cast, like this one. It's the most devastating one. Dissolve opponent. This one has the most spell learning points. Ice shower. With ice storm right behind ice ball. For whatever reason, the ice is really expensive to cast and takes a bunch of spell learning points to learn as well. Column of Fire. We have all or most of these, and Firestorm. It's really... we learn Fireball, so it's like everything from here down, plus this, and I guess Petrify. So... so that is awesome. And as you can see, if we look in this one... I think it's in this one? No. It's in this one. Ugh. No! Maybe we have them stored. Gotta be here then. Yeah, look at all that. We have Fire Pillar. That's the column of fire on the chart there. We know that, Petrify here. Wind Howler, we just learned. 19 of those things. Wind Devil. Earthquake. Here's the Ice Shower, Ice Storm, Ice Ball. Dissolve Victim. Firestorm. Awesome. Pretty happy about that. I mean, we went down. Did he gain spell points just by learning this stuff? Now I'm a bit concerned about the rations, but I think we'll be okay. I'm gonna give him one ration so he can get his points up. But unfortunately, it's the morning. Imagine walking around like that, sitting in each chair. Okay, now we'll rest. All in the same bed. Yay, so now we're gonna head back to the Tower of Lebab, I believe it is. So see you guys there. Okay guys, I'm back here, but all these caves have already been in. I don't know if there's something I missed from before. But they all go to the hill caves, which we've been to. If you can see here... I'll actually move it over. We've got, as far as the hill caves, we got one here. I don't know if you can see that. One here, and one here. I've been to all of them. This goes... somewhere. If I found a way through, I can't remember. And there's a Windgate here. Now, I couldn't keep messing around and try to find my way in. Or I could check out the wind gate. Now, I have some ideas with that, because I recently read this book. I've yet to put the video up of the reading, but I did read through it again, and who has it? It's not that. One of these. This is gonna be the last one I find. Windgate book. Alright. What does one need to use them? We need a windchain. Do we find a windchain? If you join together a chain of mother of pearl as well as... Oh, I have mother of pearl. As well as 12 wind pearls on the right altar, this will create a new wind chain. Now, we've been to this island, we couldn't figure out what to do because I forgot about this book. So we need a mother of pearl. And we also need to... I think we need to repair all these gates? A rod made of rare zenoble wood and a normal gem. The rod is used at the left altar. I don't think we have those. The rod. So as far as the wind pearls, look, we have 13 of them. We need 12. We got a moon amulet. Here's the Mother of Pearl chain. I think we might have picked up another one. Trying to avoid having to take it off him. Oh, we need to switch back his... Put the Lich Crown back on. We are the Lich Queen. Right. I wonder if I sold the other Mother of Pearl, because I didn't know what I needed it for. But the thing with the Mother of Pearl is... I'm not trying to use that. I mean, I was, but it wasn't. It increases your speed plus 5. It's nice, but... So, I don't know how to get into this place. I mean, I don't know where that... Where this cave... Oops. I don't know where that goes to. Because I've been all through these. These are the three different caves, right? Actually, this comes out here. Let me just see something. There's like nothing in here. Yeah, I don't see anything. Where are we? Alright, let's move over. Let's get out of here. Well, that's interesting that it puts you... right in the middle. Like, I actually don't recall how we got to the other part of the map that you could theoretically just walk down to. But there's a Windgate there, so I might indeed be forgetting something, in which case... well, we could still get there through the Windgate, maybe? Or do we have to repair the one on that side because it's broken? Well, I'm gonna try to make a wind chain. If we still can't get there, we'll figure it out next episode, I suppose. Okay, I need to get back to my map and get my cursor back first. And I keep losing it. Okay. Seeing where we are. Now the Windgate Island's a pain. We gotta we gotta go around this whole island to the west because it's mountains and we can't fly across. Make a big U-turn, pretty much. And we're losing daylight. Whoops. Right back down. Let's rest then. Checking the map again. So I'm gonna fly across, but I don't think this is the island. It's the next one down. But luckily, just coming from this island, we really... as long as we get out the tip here, we can't miss it. There's another wind gate, so it'd be easier for us to just run back and forth that way. Alright, so this is the wind gate. These are not broken. Oh, you have to go in here. Get me off of this thing. Just checking to make sure this altar is now out here. It's not, okay. Now it says something here. Oh, right, right. I think I translated that. Let's just save in case of anything horrible. I think we went in here, didn't we? Hard to remember sometimes. We unlocked it with the key to the shrine. And our whole character disappeared. Alright, so here's the the right and left altars. The altar has a long recess with a type of stool at its top end. Ouch, ouch. On the altar is a semicircular recess around which there are 12 similar recesses. Right. How would you figure this out back in the day? So the 12 wind pearls go there. And the semicircular recess, I guess, would be for the Mother of Pearl Gene. Well, you'd figure it out by reading the book, actually. If you missed that book, you'd be, you know, it would be random chance at that point. So, do we go use, or am I guess I'm going use. No, I'm not going use. Can I talk to it? No. We might have to split it into one at a time. No. Okay, maybe we have to do the Mother of Pearl first. The 12 wind pearls arrange themselves, oh, it just does it automatically, on the Mother of Pearl chain as if guided by a ghostly hand. In a velvety light, a wind chain now appears on the altar. Got it! The wind chain. We'll take that. Special item. Okay, what does the book say to do? Now. This will create a new wind chain. So, rod made of Zenoble wood. Well, I don't have that, right? I have Calamir herb. I have a staff of opening. Unless that's it, I don't think so, though. Arranging as I go here. So you still have one more wind pearl. I don't know what we'd do with it. Gala's club and Gala's staff. I don't think that's it. And a regular gem. Well, I'm guessing we used the staff. Nope, it's not that. I doubt it's any of the others. But I'll give it a try since we're here. Oh. That's not what I meant to do. Wrong place to use this item. I don't know what I did. We healed us or something. Yeah, those are the only staves that we have. Nothing else here, right? This is the entire place. Okay. As you step through the door, you feel a gentle draft. Strange. Okay. Before we end up someplace that's gonna have us like falling into molten lava or something like that. You don't know. Now, if we use the windchain, we might need to step back a bit. I don't know. This item now fulfills a special purpose. Okay, do we have something on the HUD here? The chain is here. Okay. We're not going anywhere, though. And I can't go use on it because it's disappeared from inventory. We'll probably need to fix the one on the other side. That one didn't have a draft? Am I not walking through it right? Okay. Yeah, I had a draft, okay. I'm just trying to try them all because... Oh! Where are we? I don't know where we are. Alright, let's rest then. I want to see the whole screen. Okay. Do I know where this is? Where's the path go? Oh, look at that. Cool. What we got here? I think maybe I've been here, I just didn't notice that. Runes faded by the weather are still visible on the signpost. There's a bridge. Oh my god, we're in Sansri's temple! Okay! Didn't know we were gonna end up over here. Okay. Good to know we can get here through the Windgate. One of the only surviving Windgates, I suppose. At least on the other side. Okay. Crap, I gotta try them all. I gotta be really thorough about it. So nothing here. I know, it's drafty. I gotta translate that too. So according to this, it's hard to see all at once. There's another broken wind gate there. Right, they're in order of two. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rows. There's 12 of them. So most of them are broken. That's annoying. So this... is it the third row? The third row. Brings us here. Don't get hurt by the water. Okay, so this is row... ah! So annoying to just have to keep resting. You didn't even accomplish much. Okay. So it's the third row, that goes to sand trees, and then this side is a draft. Fourth row. There's this one. A draft. A draft. Fifth row. We got a draft. Okay, so last row. A draft here. Okay, the only surviving one goes to Sandstreet's Island, which is in the third row somewhere. I'm not sure if we just go to Sandstreet's then. We'll try to figure out how to get back. I must have found out some way to get in there in the last video. You guys are probably yelling at me, "You just did it!" Well, in my case, it was like 2 months ago, because unfortunately I haven't been able to play this since then. So I'm going to try to keep up on it more so I don't forget stuff. At the very least, leave notes for myself. Alright, so I'm going to figure out what I'm doing next. If we're going to Sandstreet's Island, I mean, we do have a quest there to give something to someone. From the mayor, I believe. There's no quest log, really, but... we need Sansri's blood. The guards and the eagles have been turned to stone, so we need Sansri's blood. That's it, really. Alright. I don't know, are we ready to take on Sansri yet? Or should I go to Lebab's tower? Because the things around in the hill caves were not that tough. So, which makes you think we should keep going in that direction for now. At least we'll finish off that island. I kind of feel it would be a sense of completion to do that. But I have to find a way in there. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.